I've made a copy of ODB 71, and I'm calling this one ODB 72 More Grouping Part 2. I'm going into the reports, and I'm going to make a copy of ODB 71 More Grouping Part 1, the report. I'm right-clicking, copy, and right-clicking, paste. I'm going to change this to ODB 72 Grouping Part 2. Then I'm going to right-click on that and edit. I'm going down to the scroll bar and scrolling to the right. I'm going to click on the group name and come over to the width where it's 4 and change that 4 to 1.5. I want to shrink that down a little bit. I'm also going to make our group name footer a little larger. Now I'm coming up to the text field, and I want to add a text field right under this hourly wage. I'm going to make a copy of that using Control C, Control V, and hit my down arrow one time. Now I'm going to come up to the labels, and I want to add a label starting way over here. And I want that to go right next to our new text box. I want to make a copy, Control C, Control V, and one arrow down. In this first label, I want to go back to Selection Tool and select this first label. I'm going to change that to say Employees in Group. Now I'm going to click on the text box. I'm coming up to Data, and where it says Data Field Type, I want to change that from Field or Formula to be a counter. And then we want to count the number in the group. And if I click this down arrow, we could also select the number in the department or the number in the report, but we want the number in the group. Let's click on this other label that we added, and I'm going to change that to say wages for group. Then I'm going to click on our text box, come up to the data tab, field or formula, we're going to change that to be function. The data field we want is the hourly wage, and then the function will be accumulation. Let's save that and run the report and see what this looks like. Now we see we've got the number of the employees in the group, 1. Down here we've got 4, so it counts up the number in the group. Here we've got 2. And the other thing we added adds up the total wages. To make this stand out a little more, I'm going to go back into the report. I'm going to hide our properties window and stretch out our group footer a little more. I'm going to select all 4 of these and move them down just a little. Actually, I'm going to select these 2 and bring them in a little bit. So I want my alignment from the left to be in the right. Now we can close this again and bring this in a little more. Now, to make these stand out, what I'm going to do is I'm going to insert a shape. I'll make this down in the star shapes. We've got something called horizontal scroll. Need to go over to the right and get it. Move it over just so it fits pretty good. Let me bring this up a little more. We're going to have to send this to the back. Right-click, arrange, send to back. That looks pretty good. I also want to change that color. It's kind of dark. So opening up the properties, I'm going to change that fill color to be a pale yellow. Closing that back up. Oh, I want to also, this is shrunk pretty good. Let's also shrink up that footer, shrink from the bottom. Save and run. There we go. Now we see that our totals look pretty good. I'm also going to change this header. So I'm going to turn this one off, make visible no, and just use my department header. So selecting these two fields, I'm going to change the font to be Georgia, bold, 22. And make enough room up here so that they fit nicely. Bring down our underline. I'm going to have to hide our properties to see everything. Oh, we want to bring this in a little bit. Now we can bring it down. And I need to move that to the right. So we can move our department, make that fit. Department name, okay. And we'll move these both over to the right. There we go. Bring up our underline. And we can see that our department header, the whole thing shifted over, so it looks out of place, but it is really in line. The way to fix this is to save it, close, and edit again. Now we can see that our department names line up. I'm going to shrink from the bottom and see how this looks. Looks a little better. Now I'm also going to add some department totals. I'm going to select the department name, turning back on the properties, change that from 7 to about 3. And down here, we're going to do the same thing we did for our group, add in our text box. Control C, Control V, one arrow down, add in a label. Control C, Control V, one arrow down. I might have to shrink down our department name from 3. We'll make that 2. There we go. Now we can make our labels a little longer. And selecting the first one, I will change this to be employees in department. Clicking on the text box, going up to data. We want this to be the counter. Now we can see we can only choose from the grouping by the department name or for the entire report. We want department name. Let's select our other label. I want to change that to be wages for the department. Let's click on our text box and going into the data tab. We want to change this to function, data field, hourly wage, and the function will be to accumulate. I'll save that, see how that looks. I didn't give enough space for my employees in the department, so I'll make that a little longer, and I'll write justify these. And I'll also give that a quick little box. So employees in the department, selecting both of these to write justify. These two as well, we're going to write justify. Changing some of these totals uses a lot of CPU, so it may take some time. Depending on how quick your computer is, it may take longer than other times. See, mine's still clocking here. So I'm just going to wait for a moment for this to finish. All right, we're caught up. I'm going to write justify this. I'm going to make our footer a little larger. I'm going to turn off the properties. Selecting all four of our new fields in the department. Lowering that just a little. Going to the left. We want to lower these just a little. Bring that in. And I'm going to insert a shape. It's going to be a basic shape. I'm going to make a rounded rectangle. Rounded rectangle. Let's stretch this out so it fits the area we're looking at. Maybe down a little bit. Move this up. Right click. Arrangement. Send to back. Let's turn on the properties and change this fill color to be blue-gray. I will save this and run it. That looks pretty good. One more thing I'm going to do, and that is in our detail, I'm selecting the detail field. And instead of having a transparent background, I'm going to change that to no and change that background color to, we'll make it gray one. Let's save and run this. Now that's a little busy with the formatting, probably more than what one would actually put on the report. But I'm just trying to give you some ideas of how you can do some more formatting on your reports.